Hey there, good morning. Will you please stand for a moment of silence and remain standing for the pledge to the flag? I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Coming up on UPC, information on senior t-shirts.
Final golf tournament results and an interview with the cheerleaders coming up today in sports.
The Art Club will be having a meeting. All this and more is coming up on UPC, and it starts right now. Welcome to the Thursday, November 4th edition of the UPC Morning Show. I'm Sarah Orr.
And I'm Jennifer Conti. Juniors and seniors who are interested in PTEC and would like to spend a few hours at PTEC on Tuesday, November 9th, need to sign up in Guyans and pick up a field trip form by the end of the day on Friday. Senior t-shirt sales reopen on Monday, November 8th, and will continue until Wednesday, November 10th. Seniors may purchase this limited edition t-shirt during lunch in front of the media center for only $8. This will be your last opportunity. And now let's go to Katie to tell us about the dress code here at CHS.
We all know that style changes with each new year. However, this year, the school board seems to be a little less lenient on how the student chooses to dress. Do you think the dress code at Countryside is overly enforced here?
Yeah, I do. I think it makes kids rebel because they want to go against what school says, and it's ridiculous because they make people draw more attention to people, and then it makes them look stupid.
Do you like the way the school is overly enforcing the dress code?
I'm split between it. I like it because other guys aren't looking at my girlfriend so much, and I don't like it because I just think it's ridiculous.
Mr. Worth, do you think the administration this year is overly enforcing the dress code?
No, I think that this year the style of clothing maybe is a little different than the last year, and the fact that it isn't congruent with what the school board is asking for the students to wear. So I think there's more violations because of that. So I really don't think that we're enforcing it any differently. I just think that the style is different. So, and it's not the same as the school board's regulations. So it might appear that way, but I don't think we are.
You know that style changes with each new year, but now you also know that some styles just aren't fit for school. Katie Cosper, UPC.
Thanks, Katie, for that story. Come to F5 to sign up for your SeaWorld bus. Permission forms must be turned in. The Art Club will be having a meeting today, November 4th, after school in room M3. Mrs. Tan would like to thank everyone who helped out in the parade. Now here's Alfredo with the golf team results.
Thank you very much, Sarah and Jen. I'm Alfredo Muente with UPC Sports. Teeing off at approximately 6:40 a.m. yesterday in 50-degree weather with 30 miles an hour of sustained winds and a low barometric pressure with a 40-degree chance of rain, the boys' golf team finished eighth in the state golf tournament held in Haines City Tuesday and yesterday. David Cosper led Countryside shooting an immaculate 75-78-153 to place 10th out of 90, while Jimmy Fitzpatrick shot a magnificent 77-81-158, Ben Huff a torrid 80-80-160, and Chris Ford a frustrating 78-85-163. Congrats to the golf team on a great season. Also, the Lady Cougar golf team finished 9th in the state championship with a two-day total of 737. Amanda Dick shot a 157. Daryl Blakely, a Mexican pizza-like 163. Jihei Han, a Tai Chi-like 172. And Amy Stewart, an overall improved 245. Good job to the team and to Amanda for a 7th place finish in the states. The swimming and diving teams competed in their last regular meet of the season last night. They lost to Seminole, but will continue in the districts on November 12th and 13th. Scores were yesterday, Allison Pinter with a 100 IM, Kraft Wallace with a 50 free, Jackie Moser 50 back, 200 medley relay, Moser, Marin, Manning, Kraft. Girls varsity first places go to Cindy Roselle with a 50 free and 100 free, Katie Voge with a 100 fly, Liz Marlatt in the 500 free, Rainey Pearson 100 back, 200 free relay, Huff, Pearson, Marlatt, Roselle. In the boys' varsity first places, Chris Merritt in the 50 free and Brett Schreier in the 100 fly. Michael Magnuson, first place diving score of 136. And also last night, the team celebrated senior night to honor Katie Nunnally, Taryn Harrison, Nicole St. Ange, Kira Phipps, Jeanette Carbonero, and Liz Marlatt. Congratulations to anybody. Try saying that five times fast. There will be a meeting for all girls interested in playing softball today at 2 o'clock in room N13. And before our cheerleading interviews, yesterday the Tampa Bay Lightning, after an impressive Stanley Cup champion win against the Dallas Stars, had a chance to take all over the expansion ball club Atlanta Thrashers. No. 4-1 they lost yesterday, a 3-goal loss, Vincent LeCavalier providing the only offense for the Tampa Bay Lightning. Their next game will be tomorrow night. All right, and now joining us here for some cheerleading talk, we've got Daniela Cicero and Sarah Eichler. Girls, thank you for joining us on the show today. Sarah, tell us, how has the season been going?
We've done real well this year. We're planning on going to a county competition coming up in December, and then perhaps at the states.
What do you guys have planned for us tomorrow night against Ridgewood?
We're really excited. It's an important win for the football team, so we just want everybody to show up and support the team.
Thank you very much. The football team tomorrow, of course, they will be playing on Ridgewood for their final home game of the season. A win against that district foe, and the team automatically clinches a playoff spot for the second consecutive year. They'll look to do that for the first time in school history. Thank you guys for joining us today. Thank you. And that'll do it today in sports. Now back to you guys.
Thanks, Alfredo, and congratulations to the golf team. There will be a special homeroom held for seniors next Wednesday, November 10th, after first period. Information and order forms for graduation announcements will be made available, and applications for graduation will be handed out. There will be an SAT-ACT review at Clearwater Adult Education Center at Clearwater High School. Classes begin November 1st and meet on Mondays and Wednesdays at 6 p.m. Classes meet for 3 hours. Tuition for the 24-hour course is $48. Students will register in the classrooms on the first night. This course is scheduled to prepare students for the January test date. For further information, call 469-4190. Again, that number is 469-4190. You can call this number between 2 and 9 p.m. Monday through Thursday.
There will be a Christians in Action meeting today in room B7. They will be singing praise and worship songs and getting in the Word. Come join them for a great time. There will be no evening tutoring next Wednesday, November 10th, at the Countryside Library. And here are some last-minute announcements. Happy birthday to Victor. Love always your Scorpio friend.
Happy birthday to Lacey Rains from your brother, Victor, and all your friends.
There will be an Interact meeting Thursday at 2 p.m. in the Media Center.
And that's all we have.
Bye. Bye.
The day, and I start to struggle. Who will I obey? Temptation surrounds me, trying to resist. But I may end up winning or end up caving in. This is life on the edge.